I joined the Marine Corps in 1970, right out of high school.
I lived that life, breathed it.
It's a typical military base. Jacksonville, North Carolina. We stayed at Camp Lejeune until December of 1975, and that was when Janie was conceived.
Sergeant Jerry Ensminger, what was his role in this?
Well, Master Sergeant Jerry Ensminger was a drill instructor and was a Marine for nearly 25 years. When he was living at Camp Lejeune, his wife was pregnant with their second child. And that child, Janie, when she was 6 years old, was diagnosed with a rare type of leukemia. And unfortunately, she succumbed to that, to the illness when she was nine.
The contaminants found in the water at Lejeune have been linked in scientific literature to birth defects and childhood cancers.
My first thought was this what happened to Janie?
I dropped my plate right there.
He came up with documents and paperwork and realized that the water at Camp Lejeune had been contaminated for 30 years, and no one had been notified who had lived at the base that they were exposed to these contaminants that were considered harmful.
But if there were documentation, then officials at some level, presumably in the Department of Defense, knew there were contaminants in that water.
Precisely.
Did you learn, to your satisfaction, or did he to his, why people were not informed about this danger to their own health?
I don't think there's been an official Marine Corps answer to that question.
Why has DOD not notified those residents at Camp Lejeune that they may have been exposed to TCE or PCE? Don't you think you have responsibility to let these people know they may have been exposed?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then why don't you do it?
That would be a very difficult and laborious task. We could try, but I could never commit to finding 100% of people who may have been exposed. That would be very difficult.
I think a lot of people, when they hear that up to 1 million people were potentially affected by these contaminants over 3 decades, will themselves lose some faith in our institutions, our government. Did you?
I went into this really believing that at the core of things, that our government was protecting us. Mm-hmm. And I have to say, after making the film, I'm less confident in those agencies that are set to protect us and their ability to protect us than I was going in.
And the title, Semper Fi, why did you choose? Obviously, that's the Marine motto, but why did you choose that for the title? Does that say something?
You know, Semper Fidelis, which means always faithful, to me really encapsulated the betrayal of the situation of the servicemen and women who were at Camp Lejeune.
I blamed myself for years till this came out. I hated myself, I hated my body, because I thought I had failed my children. I have 2 graves out in Onslow Memorial Park. I would appreciate it if y'all would take in consideration that we are not numbers in a study. We are human beings that have had great tragedies. And the pain never leaves. Rusty would be 30 years old on the 30th of this month. The pain is no less. Thank you.
I think the first thing that we were trying to really show in the film is the power of one individual who's so determined and so focused to really make a difference.
I am appearing here today as one spokesperson for the hundreds of thousands of Marines, sailors, their families, and loyal civilian employees who were unknowingly exposed to horrendous levels of toxins through their drinking water at Camp Lejeune, North Carolina.
What do you want viewers to come away from the documentary with? What do you want them to learn or do?
There's pending legislation to help the people who were exposed to the water and potentially provide health care for them. So I think that there is a need to support that legislation that's pending both in the House and the Senate. So hopefully the audiences will be motivated to contact their local congresspeople to be able to push some of that support through.
Best of luck to you next week.
Thank you so much.
Okay, take care.